Hey everyone, welcome back to my channel. If you haven't watched my previous videos, do check them out. We have seen few errors already. We saw type error, name error, as well as some syntax errors throughout our journey with Python. Our users can break our code at any time when they do something unexpected. These types of errors are called exceptions. When this happens, the user experience goes down and they start to move away from our application. You might have seen some web applications not responding when you try to fill up a form and submit. Those are also situations when something went wrong on the server-side code while processing your form data. The server-side code could be written in any language, Python, PHP, Java, or C#, but you don't want to frustrate your users with that kind of response. In this video, I will show you how you can handle exceptions in Python. Let's write a simple program that throws an error when user provides invalid inputs that we didn't expect. This program simply takes two numbers from user and we want to print the sum of these two numbers. Let's take first number, input, enter first number. To convert this input into integer, wrap this statement in int function. Take second input, num2, in a similar way. So let's copy this line and paste it here. Let's change this variable to num2 and this word first to second. Let's simply print simple calculator here. And in the second line, print the answer is. And in string interpolation, we can write num1 plus num2. When I execute this, it asks for user input. Let's say the user enters 1 and hit enter. Right away, it throws an error with this complicated stack trace. It's a value error on this specific line. You can see it in this stack trace. The user doesn't have any clue what this stack trace means. Ideally, we should not show this ugly looking stack traces to our users. There are many reasons for that. First of all, users don't have any idea on what these messages mean. Second, it can be a security risk for our code base. So, is there a way we can avoid showing this to our users? Luckily, there is a way to do this. If you think that this code can throw an error, you should wrap it inside the try block. We can write try and it's a block. Now, I'm taking user input in these two lines of code. And users can provide anything as inputs which can throw an error. So I can wrap these two lines in the try block and then we can write accept block. Here we write which type of error we are expecting. We know that it can throw a value error when user enters incorrect number. So let's start with that. And inside this accept block, we can do something to handle this error situation. In our case, we can simply inform our users that they need to enter digits. Let's write simple print statement that's not exactly a number. Please enter digits. Now execute this code. Let's enter 2 and again we get an error. But look, this is a different error. It's a name error and this time it's on this line as we can see from the stack trace. The problem was that it was looking for this variable num1, but on the right hand side when it tried to cast this string input to a number, it throws an exception and this assignment never happened. That's why it's unable to find num1 variable. In such cases, try except also provides else block. If there is no error, only then we should print this result statement. So let's move these two lines of code inside the else block and let's execute the code. Now if I enter string 2, it gives us this message. That's not exactly a number. If I enter correct numbers 2 and 3, we get this message with result 5. If I replace this plus sign with a division and we try to execute with values 5 and 2, it works perfectly fine. But let's see what happens if I specify the values 3 and 0. This time it throws an error again. It's a zero division error. It prints this message as well, which doesn't look good. We could also handle this situation by adding another except block, which can handle zero division error, just like we did for value error. But ideally, we should throw an error as early as possible in order to save some computing resources. In real applications, the user input may trigger many other actions and may use computer resources before eventually failing at some point. If you know that these are not valid inputs, it's better to throw an error. There is no way we can divide a number by zero. In this case, we should not be taking denominator of value 0. We should throw an error when user provides 0 as denominator. We can throw value error. So let's add if block, if num2 equals 0. To throw an error, we can use the keyword raise. And then we specify the type of error we want to throw. We want to throw value error. We can also provide the error message in the pair of parentheses. So let's write simple message. Division by 0 is not possible. Please provide non-zero denominator value. We are catching these value errors in the except block, so it should be fine. Let's run this code. Provide values 3 and 0. And we get back this message. However, it doesn't give any clue of the error. We can get this error message we provided in the pair of parentheses so that we can provide better clarity. We can use as keyword and give some name to this error. So we write as error. And to get the error message, we can simply use the print statement. Print error. If I execute this code and provide values 3 and 0, it prints this message, division by 0 is not possible, as an error message. If this error was not handled in the except block, it would suddenly exit our script with stack traces. But we have this except block, so it executes everything inside this except block and then exits gracefully without any stack traces. So those are try and except blocks in Python to handle errors. And we also saw raise keyword for throwing our own errors. Thank you so much for watching this video. I hope this was useful for you. Please like, subscribe, and comment on it if you have any questions or recommendations. I will see you in the next video lesson.